have to have proof that Timmy's been used.
Oh, right.
Easy way, just go through and see what they recorded. Most people recorded something.
So do you read the caution at the beginning when you're first speaking to them?
You ascertain that you're speaking to the right person first. So literally you're knocking at the door, hello, do you live here? That's an opening gambit, or you've got a name, Mr. Your license expired, it ran out a few months ago, was there a problem? Has there been a reason why you haven't paid? No, okay, well, let me sort it out with you now. As soon as you've done that, we know maybe you're Mr. B. I still don't know who you are, but all I know is Mr. B. I know nothing else.
Mm.
So then I'll write out as much as I can, I'll put your address down, I'll ask you what your first name is, hopefully you'll tell me, and then I'm going to caution you. I can establish you live there, I can establish your name and the address, I can establish that there's a TV, that's the reason for my coming round.
Hmm.
I can establish that you don't have a licence, again, that's my reason for coming round, and that's it. You live there, you've got a TV, you haven't got a licence, now I can caution you. Until then,
so you can get that evidence before you caution them?
While you're doing that, they're going to tell you they've got Sky, they're going to tell you all sorts of other things, and that's the bit you keep up in your head, because you'll need that information later. When you get some of the guys will actually stand there, and some of the tip I saw, which I thought was really good, it's like, just got to read your caution, and you just put your pen up, they look at the pen, and you just bring the pen down, and you just run across, and then they start following the pen. So there's never any argument that you've not given the caution.
Oh, when you find that, they're more likely to read the whole thing then?
At least they've tuned into what you're doing. So then they can't use an excuse that he never gave me the caution, he never did this, he never did that. But people will try that from time to time.
And what happens if they say, I don't watch TV?
Ask them to check.
Oh.
Ask them to go and check. So you go and check the TV, have a look at it.
And what happens if they say you're not allowed in?
Walk away. Nothing you can do. We can't kick the door down. However, as part of the training, it will become apparent that we do have other means that we can use. Search warrant. We keep getting the same negative response from somebody, then we'll apply for a search warrant, which will involve another visit. Generally, a manager will go around and try and sweet talk the customer, see if we can sort them out, the situation out. If we can't, then the paperwork goes back in. They then get a strongly worded letter telling them they've got 8 weeks to comply. After 8 weeks, they don't comply. We get a search warrant from the court, go down there with a couple of police officers, ourselves and an officer, and take the statement. That's a guaranteed conviction. And that's
but they'd have to be watching TV?
We have to have proof that TV's been used.
Oh, right.
Easy way, just go through and see what they recorded. Most people recorded something. Friends, EastEnders, Coronation.
Oh, you mean because TVs now have the, like Sky, you can record the programme?
Yeah,
what, so you'll go in and would I be doing this? So you go in and then you ask them to switch on the TV and then you look through their planner or whatever they have?
Absolutely, have a look through. If they're denying it, you go straight onto that, have a look and say, well, you recorded that yesterday or something. People contact us and tell us there is no TV set in the property. So we have a gentler version of a visit to those people, just go around and double check.